It's that time again. It's film vlog time, and I've been told to say Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Yeah. As you can see, they are more regular, but I don't think they'll be this regular. two in one day is a lot, so there you go. So this time, this one's been planned for a while. We were meaning to go see it when it came out, but then illness fell upon the kingdom of our house. So we've had to hold it off, but we've finally seen it. Life of Pi. Whatever.
No, it is Pi.
Yeah, it is Pi. Based on a really popular book, which was given free as a iTunes 12 Days of Christmas
I
gift.
I have it. I still not have read it.
Yeah, I've got it. I still haven't read it.
Have not read it.
Yeah, so... But I would like to.
Yeah.
I was meaning to read it before I went to see this anyway, and I would like to read it. Done by Ang Lee, who's known for doing
Brokeback Mountain,
Hulk, the really bad Hulk film.
Didn't know
yeah,
that.
With that in the back of my mind going into this, I was like,
Yeah, but you haven't seen Brokeback Mountain, which
no, I haven't seen Brokeback Mountain. It is on my list, by the way, to watch. By the way, Brokeback Mountain. So I'll start this one.
Yeah,
I want to start this one. As I said, I went in it with the Hulk in mind, and I was like, But I know Ang Lee's a very good director, so I thought... And another fear I had in my mind was a lot of the marketing has been saying, this is the next Avatar, and I thought, is it going to be pretty with no plot? Safe to say, my suspicions were blasted away very quickly. The opening credits were enough to say this is going to be a very, very good film. I mean, the opening credits play with what's on screen. And which is very, very nice to see, because it's not just, oh yeah, let's slap a couple of titles over some pretty imagery. You can tell a lot of effort's gone into this film. As I said, even from the opening credits, you can see a lot of effort has gone into it. There was times where I thought, it's only in the opening credits, where I thought, what was the point in using a CG elephant just to walk past a camera? But there you go. I suppose elephants are hard to train.
Was it CG?
Yeah, the elephant was CG, you could tell. Very, very pretty film. Very, very pretty. Every shot was like something a painter has put together. It was such a beautiful film to look at. Very gorgeous in its cinematography and everything. Imagery-wise, it was absolutely fantastic. The story was brilliant as well. It was inspirational. It was heartfelt. It had the power to make you laugh, then cry, and then... want to kick the shit out of people talking all the way through it, but we'll probably talk about that later in the review. But I absolutely loved the film. There were a couple of times where I felt it was dragging on a little bit, but that's the way it goes, unfortunately, with some films. But all in all, I really did enjoy it. I said I thought it was a very pretty film to look at, and the story was a good story. It wasn't just a film that was made to go, ooh, that's pretty. You can tell this was based on a book because it had a lot of substance to it. So I really enjoyed the film.
There's not much I can add to that. I like the fact that you also mentioned the credits, because that was the first thing I picked up on when the film started was, oh, I love these credits. It's literally just animals in the zoo.
And some CG animals in a zoo.
I just love the fact that the credits and that would dance along with the animals or float in the water or even vanish behind them. There was a lot of what I liked in this film was the way the scenes sort of faded into each other. You'd have the foreground stay there like a person, and then the next scene would appear in the background and then the foreground would vanish.
Yeah.
It was really bizarre, but
yeah.
I really liked it. It kind of kept... It wasn't like jump shots or anything.
There wasn't a lot of jump cuts.
It
just flowed.
And music was very nice as well. I mean, I thought when we were... sitting there in the credits at the end, I was like, oh, I have to find out who did the music, because I thought it was very sort of Thomas Newman, who does he's done Finding Nemo and Shawshank Redemption and all that kind of, he's very, very famous, he's got a very distinct sound, but it was like that, but with an Indian, bit of Indian influence in it. I really liked it. It's really hard, I know what everyone says, visually it is stunning, and you can't deny that, really. I don't think that's the biggest part of it. I think the story is the main part that people will remember, but the trailers are all about the visuals and that, and it's true, there is a lot in there. The whole film has this kind of dreamlike quality, like you're in you're in this dream world, because when he's at sea, all the skies and everything, and the water just looks like paintings and like
the fact that the sign that at times the sky and the sea just blending, meld together.
Yeah, it's very, I think
it's a very art lover's film.
From a personal standpoint, I'm a sucker for these kind of life story films. I love like Forrest Gump and Shawshank Redemption, like Gilbert Grape. I like stories about these just really normal, mundane people
going on extraordinary
things, or I just find them very fascinating. So this was good enough for me. And then, of course, you had all the visuals in there, and it's all set at sea as well. So there was a slow like scenes underwater with all like big fish and that, and oh, it's
and jellyfish.
The jellyfish scenes and that, and yeah, it was very emotional film as well. You know, there was a lot of tears in there, and I really liked the character of Pi. I thought he was really nice.
He was genuine.
With him, you know, just the one person pulling the whole film, he was a very genuine character. You really felt for him. You were on this journey with him.
What was the tiger called?
Richard something? Barker?
Richard Parker. Yeah, the lion has the name of Richard Parker, which is awesome in my eyes. An animal having a proper human name is brilliant.
Richard Parker or Richard Barker or something like that. Really bland name.
But the way he gets the name is quite funny as well.
Same with how he's called Pi, because I think a lot of people went this film thinking, why is he called Pi? And is that something to do with math? Which ironically it is. Then he's also got like his real name as well, which is really funny, and quite a little story behind that is quite interesting. There was something I wanted to like.
I think that's the problem with the film. Like, there's so much
going in.
There's so much that you get out of it, which is hard to try and convey in something as simple as this. I really do believe this is one of those films you really well and truly have to experience in the cinema. But well, first viewing,
a lot of people have said 3D
A first viewing has to be in the cinema. See, now I'm going to disagree with that, because when I was watching the film, I could clearly see where your £10 was being spent on two shots. I could clearly see it. It was really obvious. There's a scene where it goes, suddenly changes into a 16:9, like a proper 16:9 with the black bars on the top. And there's loads of fish and stuff, and the fish are going over the black bars. And obviously we saw it in 2D. And I just kept thinking, yeah, here's the £10 scene.
See, I didn't notice the black bar.
Yeah, I did.
You're too much of a film person.
Well, yeah, I'm a film person.
Yeah, but it's just, you need to get invested in the film and ignore.
Oh no, I
the frame.
I get invested in it, but I notice things like that very quickly. And as I said, I could see. I think there was two scenes which I saw.
The comic book kind of thing at the beginning.
See, I don't know. I didn't think that would be a 3D bit.
Oh it was.
I think the 3D bits were, as I said, the bit with the fish, and then there's a bit where he's got his stick and he's pointing it at the camera. There's your £10 there. That's your ten.
I think a lot of it would have been, there would have been the comic bit where he's looking at the comic and then it goes inside the comic and then there's all planets and stuff. That was 3D that was there. But I don't know, I kind of wish I had seen it in 3D a little bit. But then we would have had to pay extra. And I'm a cheapskate. I wouldn't have been able to get me nachos.
But that was the only, that's the only sort of criticism I have, is I could clearly see where the 3D was going to be, and I could be wrong. We could have gone and seen it in 3D. And I could have been like, wow, oh my god, this is amazing. Like when I went to see Avatar in 3D.
I've heard people that hate 3D saying that they like this.
So yeah,
I'll give it the best.
But as I was saying, I really do believe this has to be a film for your first viewing. You have to go to a cinema, hopefully a quiet one. Dark room, nice surround sound system, good chair, and just experience it. Because as much as people, I mean, someone could write the best review in the world of it, but I don't think it will compare to you actually seeing it, because it's one of those that has to be visually experienced to truly appreciate what it is.
I think that there is one other sort of thing I'd have to mention is, a good chunk of the movie is spent just this guy on his own with a CGI animal.
Yeah.
Mostly CGI.
Well, yeah, because
there are times when it's not.
Yeah, there are times when it's a real. tidier.
Considering, sometimes you can tell when it's CGI and that, but considering that, it's still really good. You kind of don't care. It's almost like when Frodo and Sam are hanging out with Gollum. You know Gollum's not really there, but you get
so invested in the character.
Yeah, you got invested in the tiger and the orangutan and all that. You kind of...
Yeah.
You really...
You're quite amazed by, as you were saying, but it proves the point that it's story that makes a film and not the pretty pictures. Because as you said, at times, yes... And I even said you could tell when certain things in it were computer generated, but you didn't care because the story was that well done that you were quite happily sitting there thinking, yeah, that's not there, but I don't care because this story's good enough for me to believe in it.
It's called the willing suspension of disbelief.
Exactly.
I did have one or two criticisms, but I can't really remember what they are, so they can't have been that big. I think one of them might have been just when you could tell. Yeah. The animals were CGI.
Yeah.
And, but like I said, they're not massive. I did have one weird thought sitting in there. The big storm scene with the ship, when you're on the ship. And I just kept thinking, yeah, I'd be out on the deck doing that too. Because it looked like a lot of fun.
Sliding around.
Except when everyone died. It was like, oh, okay.
Yeah. But one thing I will say about... You've probably heard little bits and pieces coming out in this review about... hopefully a quiet cinema and things like that. I'm going to have a little rant now. Seriously, people, if you pay to go see a film...
Or not, because everyone else is paying.
Yeah, well, we've got Cineworld Unlimited tickets, so technically we have paid. But if you're paying to go see a film...
Shut the fuck up!
Yeah, be quiet. We don't need a director's comment. We don't need a... Oh, there's the tiger! Oh, he's having his dinner now.
There's literally an old woman with her husband on my left, sort of about 10 feet away. Oh, he's going to drown if he doesn't help him out. Oh, look at that fish, Phil. Oh, it's like Jojo in the background or something. it was really fucking annoying. And obviously, I can't go up and punch an old woman in the face.
No.
And you can't say anything.
I think I had a family behind me as well.
Oh, they were rabbiting.
And they were rabbiting on going... Oh, that. Have you seen
Did
that?
Did you see that? Yeah, yeah. It's only on the 20, 30 foot TV in front of me.
Yeah. I think the problem with the world at the moment is our living rooms, because so many people don't go to the cinema anymore, our living rooms have become our cinemas to a degree. And when they go to a cinema, they forget the cinema code of conduct. But we're getting really off topic now. So, final thought.
It's awesome. Go watch it. And I'm not saying awesome in the sense like, dude, it's awesome. I'm saying it's awe-inspiring. It's very... It's a lovely story. I think anyone can follow it. I think kids can follow it. There are dark elements, but I'd let my kids watch it.
Yeah.
I think there were children in there as well. There was. I think everyone needs to see it. And I think even people that aren't really film people, there's about 30 seconds worth of subtitles in it, so you don't need to be afraid even though there's an Indian character in it.
Yeah.
It's mostly in English.
Yeah, it's mostly in English.
And silence.
There's even a bit of French in it as well.
Yeah.
Gerard Depardieu!
He had a tiny cameo. He's fat.
Gerard Depardieu!
Gerard Depardieu.
Aye, exactly.
The only film I know him from is 101 Dalmatians, the movie.
Anyway, my final thoughts, as I said, it's a very pretty film to look at. Thankfully, it has a really good story as well, so it ticks both boxes perfectly. As I said, it was awe-inspiring. It was emotional. It's as I said, you need to go see this in a... This is a cinema experience film.
A good start to 2013.
Yeah, it was a good start to 2013. You know, this came out in 2012. It's a good start for 2013. It's like when people saw Avatar and they said, you've got to see this in the cinema. I feel this is one of those as well that you need to see in the cinema, because you need to see on a big screen, as I said, surround sound, dark room, hopefully quiet, and you will enjoy it because it's just everything's there for you. So you will enjoy the film. You will. Well,
we've got a few more coming up this month.
Yeah, we have.
Because we got the tickets now, so... We're going to see films.
Yeah, we've got the Unlimited Cineworld tickets, so now we're going to see films very regularly. That's why these things are going to come more regular. So, I think next on the chopping block...
Les Miserables? Or The Quartet?
Oh, maybe The Quartet. We'll see how we feel. Then Les Mis. Then it's then it's gonna be Gangster Squad. Then it's gonna be, I think it's something else. And then
Django Unchained. Or is that
Django Unchained? Yeah, which looks awesome. And then after that, Wreck-It Ralph. We've got tickets to an early screening of Wreck-It Ralph. Unfortunately, in 3D, but hey ho.
You know, it might be good.
Yeah, it might be good in 3D. It's bright and colourful.
I can't wait for Wreck-It Ralph.
Hi.
At last. We literally bought the unlimited tickets just so we could see this preview screening, and I don't even care. It's going to be awesome.
Hi. Right, well, that's it. So, all in all, it sounds like it's a very positive look on Life of Pi, and that's about it. So, we'll see you next time for whatever film it is.
Toodles. And toast.